Hello, so I'm with Eloise Oizan, a professor of the Interactive Games and Media Department at the Rochester Institute of Technology. How are you doing?
I'm good.
So we actually just are coming back from GDC 16, getting back from San Francisco. So what would you say your biggest takeaway from GDC was?
My biggest takeaway from GDC? Good question. You even told me the questions before I got here. Let's see. Biggest takeaway from GDC is that our students are our learning process, and that's a good thing. It's a given that the students that come through the game design and development program have to be good programmers. But what I was getting from it was they're learning how to think and create and work as teams. And that seems to be the biggest part of everything. And they're doing well, which makes me very happy.
What do you think your favorite part of GDC 16 was?
My favorite part of GDC 16 was seeing where each of my former students had ended up and finding out exactly how they were putting what they learned to use. One of the big pieces was I teach 2D animation and 3D modeling and animation, along with game design. I think my favorite part was having a discussion with, give me a moment, Steve Ohawa GBA. Everyone calls him Steve-O, but his last name is very important. Ohawa GBA, I'll say that again, because I was able to learn it. He was talking about how it was really important that he did all the animation bits, because that made him a better game programmer. This in terms of having just the right feel of programming, just the right amount of jump, and seeing how that affected his gameplay. Sometimes I don't know exactly where art fits in the GDD program. I know it's important. I know it's important for design. But hearing him say that he was taking what he learned and applying it to his programming and coding to make more effective games was a revelation. And it gives me more ammo to go back and say, see, this is important and this is why.
Nice, yeah. Yeah, I think it's true, I mean, across all GDC, right? So we saw a lot of new tools for art, a lot of new tools for programming, lots of new engines, and lots of cool interactive things kind of combining them together. So UE4 is now doing it, or has someone actually making it for cartoon shows, right? Mm-hmm. Someone's actually using that as kind of an animation tool, but it combines programming to do something kind of different from what we've seen previously. You actually playtested one of your new games going out to be published, the open playtest, which was Hexes.
Yes.
How'd the playtest go?
The playtest, as most playtests go, things are broken. Things will be broken whether it be a digital game or an analog game. My game is a card game. Rule number one, rules are hard, and you can't assume that anyone will read them, and it's hard to just lay all the technical specs out so people understand what they're supposed to do. Little things, some cards do not play well with other cards. Some people do not play well with other people, but that's all part of the design process. We have to go consider all of that.
Yeah, I think GDC was really good, so kind of mirroring what Eloise was saying. It was good. I saw a lot of my students, saw a lot of people who are now in industry making good contacts. I think the biggest thing for me, biggest kind of takeaway is VR is big, right? So VR was a big thing, something I hadn't immediately considered. It was a very cool thing. It's always been a cool thing. It was something I hadn't immediately considered to be a giant contender until this GDC, where everyone was using VR for everything. Right. Well, it was really cool though, because I got to try out some of the new demos, and it's given me a strong promise that there is a future there. Right, that the technology is not just a throwaway technology, but it's actually really now. I mean, it's real now. Right? We have cool technology now. We can actually apply it to things, and I think people already are. So we have a whole bunch of different companies who are showing out their new demo. We had Lucky's Tale, which showed 3D cameras in VR, which I think people weren't really considering up until that point, or hadn't proven up to that point. So Lucky Tale did a whole third-person camera game, but using VR, right? So you can actually look around, and it makes the game feel good. I mean, it actually feels right, even though you're wearing a headset. And I don't think that was the original intention of a lot of these VR games. That was really cool. I think as far as the, my favorite part of being there is just the conference is amazing. So if you ever get a chance, I do recommend it. So we actually, all of us who went for this Quadrupod game, had a great time. We got to meet lots of new people, and that's what happens every year is we get to meet lots of new people across the country, across the, multiple countries, across all these big game studios, people I've known about and actually have read their work. I just run into them in coffee shops, right? It's great to see that. It's great to make these new connections, see people I knew, kind of converge. As far as the Quadrupod game, we're actually all in different parts of the country. So this is as much as we work and are actively working together and communicating over Skype, this was actually the first chance we ever had to be in the same location. And that's part of the wonderful part of GDC. This year there was 27,000 people, which was the biggest GDC yet, all converging into San Francisco, which is a wonderful and beautiful city. So we had a really good week, right? We had a great week to meet people, great week for us to meet up. It was all good stuff. Our playtest. Thank you for everyone who actually came to the playtest. Hopefully you get to see Eloise's game Hexes there as well. But thank you for anyone who came. It went really well. I mean, we're just starting now getting back to our places, starting to analyze stuff. I've already started pulling the data out, which is a very quick turnaround time. It's kind of exhausting, but starting to pull out the data, and it's really good. I mean, people are giving us wonderful feedback, so I really appreciate that people came out for it. Some things we knew, some things we didn't know, and then my favorite part was just seeing what all you guys did to project yourself into the game, right? Saying like, wow, I really want this in the game. Like, this is my game, this is what I would do. And that's exciting for us because it actually shows us that our game is viable, that people care about it enough to project what they want into it and kind of want a piece of themselves in it. And that gives us a lot of courage that we can actually do this. And it gives us all these wonderful ideas to go off of. So I appreciate that. Thank you very much. I think that's about it.